Ever been to one of those concerts that just totally like takes you somewhere
Oh,
else?
yeah, absolutely. There are some musicians who are so talented that they can really transport you.
Totally.
Yeah.
And that's what we're gonna like dive into today. This whole idea of music as an experience, not just entertainment. Specifically, we're checking out this Miami guitarist, Cesarius.
Oh, I've heard of him. He's the rumba flamenca guy, right?
Exactly. What's fascinating about Cesarius is that he understands something that I think a lot of artists miss these days.
Okay.
Music,
Yeah.
it's not confined to like the stage anymore, you
Yeah.
know?
Yeah.
It's about crafting an experience. And he really gets that. And he's doing it with this incredible blend of musical talent and like savvy business moves.
So let's set the stage for anyone who's maybe just tuning in. You know, we've got articles, we've got reviews, we've even got some like behind the scenes glimpses into how this guy operates. And I'm telling you, the word energetic,
Right.
it doesn't even begin to cover it.
It doesn't even scratch the surface.
But it's clear there's a method to his music. This isn't just about putting on a good show, right?
Exactly. And that's where this gets really interesting because
Okay.
we're about to unpack how he's built a career that's as much about cultural fusion.
Okay.
He's really found this sweet spot where like artistry and smart business decisions harmonize beautifully.
So let's talk about the music itself.
Yeah, let's get into it.
This rumba flamenca style he's known for. I have to admit, even just reading those words, I'm already picturing something
Oh,
lively,
yeah.
exciting, high energy.
And you wouldn't be wrong.
Yeah.
You know, imagine the heart-pounding rhythms and like the fiery passion of Spanish flamenco, right?
Oh, yeah.
But then you weave in the captivating rhythms of rumba.
Well, that speaks to the speed, the precision, the sheer dexterity he displays. It's like his fingers are flying across the strings, but every note is crystal clear.
Wow, I can only imagine the kind of practice and dedication it takes to reach that level. And don't forget the singing. He sings in both English and Spanish, and this he's learning like a bunch of other languages too.
No way. Seriously. That's incredible. What, like Italian, Mandarin, something like that?
Italian, Tagalog, Greek, even a little Portuguese.
Wow, that's commitment. It's obvious that this isn't just a performance for him, it's about making a connection. He wants everyone in the audience to feel like the music is speaking directly to them, no matter where they come from.
Yeah, exactly. It's like he's saying music is a universal language, but he's taking it a step further and actually learning those languages. And Cesario's, luckily, glowing reviews.
That's good.
One client even rebooked him after 2 years.
Wow.
That says something.
She has a good impression.
Yeah. And one that stood out to me,
What's that?
someone said he remembers everyone's
Big
names.
out.
Yeah.
Even after performing for tons of people.
That's like next level social skill.
I know, right? Makes you want to meet the guy.
Definitely.
Talking about his shows on cruises, standing room only.
Wow.
Clearly been rocking crowds for years. This guy's set list is huge, GE. Oh.
I mean, seriously massive.
Okay.
You're talking over 2,800 songs a year.
Seriously.
Like, it's exhilarating and elegant all at once.
So not just a fusion of sounds, but a fusion of cultures too.
Exactly.
I can totally see why it's described as having this upscale, high-energy vibe. It feels almost like a global experience, doesn't
And it's
it?
totally intentional.
Wow.
Cesarius isn't just like haphazardly blending genres.
Right.
He's carefully selecting these threads to create a very specific tapestry. You know,
Wow.
speaking to something much deeper within us.
Speaking of global, can we talk about the sheer range of instruments this guy
That's
incorporates?
incredible.
The guitar is a given,
Of course.
but he's got the mandolin, the charango from the Andes,
Yeah.
the Cuban tres, the Puerto Rican cuatro, even the Greek bouzouki.
Amazing.
It's like a musical United Nations up there.
And that's where you see the why behind Cesarius's choices.
Okay.
This isn't just about like adding exotic flair.
Right.
It's a very deliberate decision to showcase these musical traditions from around the world.
Right.
He's not just a musician,
Yeah.
he's a cultural ambassador using his platform to celebrate the diversity and the beauty of music across continents.
Wow.
Yeah.
And it's not just the instruments themselves, it's
Yeah.
the way he like weaves them together. You know, you
Absolutely.
can just hear these echoes of different continents, different cultures,
Yeah.
all blending seamlessly in his music.
It's true.
It makes you want to grab a passport.
I know I'm ready to book a flight.
Right.
And that actually segues perfectly into his whole immersive experience concept.
Okay.
These elegant venues, warm lighting,
Yeah.
this whole ambiance that's designed to like transport the audience. He's not just performing, he's curating a world.
It's like the difference between looking at a postcard
right.
and actually stepping into that scene.
Exactly.
You're not just hearing the music, you're experiencing it with all your senses.
You're there.
Yeah.
So he's turned his music into a destination.
Now that's smart.
Right.
That's some smart marketing there.
It really is.
He's giving people a taste of the world.
Yeah.
But within, you know, the luxury of a five-star experience.
Absolutely.
But then there's that encore element.
Yes.
The blindfolded finale.
Oh, yeah.
Playing with the eyes of the heart, as he calls it.
Right.
Now, that's a power move.
It's incredibly powerful and on, like, so many levels.
Okay.
Like, artistically, just from a pure skill standpoint.
Yeah.
To play these intricate instruments blindfolded,
right,
relying solely on muscle memory and feeling.
Yeah.
That's next level skill.
During these blindfolded performances,
yeah,
the energy in the room is like palpable.
Oh yeah.
Like everyone's holding their breath.
It's captivating.
Completely captivating.
It creates this incredible tension,
mm-hmm,
and this intimacy.
Wow.
And then on top of that, it speaks volumes about breaking down barriers.
Oh.
He's removing sight.
Yeah.
Arguably our most dominant sense,
right,
and saying, listen with your whole being.
Wow.
It's a really powerful message about the universality of music. Okay. It's like the artists he's inspired by.
Cool.
Everyone from Paco de Lucia, Tomatito, those flamenco legends,
mm-hmm,
but also like Dire Straits, Metallica.
Well, that's a range.
It's all over the place, different genres, eras. What songs does he choose?
That gets specific.
That's where it gets juicy.
For Grady.
So, huge set list. We know that.
Thousands of songs, right.
But it's not just random.
Meaning?
There are, like, themes you see.
Yeah.
He's got an easy listening section.
Okay. Makes sense.
Classics, you know, Fly Me to the Moon, that kind of thing.
Crowd pleasers.
Then instrumental songs.
Like what?
Iconic stuff.
Okay.
The Godfather theme. Classical gas.
Oh, I see. The recognizable ones.
It's like he's thinking about the experience.
Creating a certain vibe.
Not just throwing songs together.
Mm-hmm. It's curated. It gives me chills just thinking about it.
I know.
Okay, so we've got this incredibly talented musician.
Yes.
Crafting these really richly layered cultural experiences.
Mm-hmm.
And then we get to the business side of things.
Right.
And let me tell you.
Yeah.
Caesarius doesn't miss a beat.
And that's what I think is so fascinating about this whole deep dive.
Okay.
Because he really understands that music is more than just art.
Right.
It's also a business.
Yeah.
And he's not afraid to make these really savvy decisions that support both.
Like the post-performance wine and cheese expos.
Exactly.
They mention another rumba flamenca duo performing.
Yeah.
It's like a subtle way to keep those global vibes flowing.
It's brilliant.
Yeah.
Think about it.
Okay.
You've just been on this incredible musical journey around the world.
Yeah.
And just as you're coming down from that high, you're treated to more music, delicious food, good company.
It's the after party you never want to end.
Exactly.
And let's not forget those vacation giveaways for his VIP followers.
Mm-hmm.
He's turned his audience into a global community.
It's true. And the hotels get to tap into his dedicated fan base.
Mm.
It's symbiotic marketing at its finest.
Okay, so we've covered a lot of ground here.
We have.
The music, the cultural fusion, the business acumen.
Right.
If we had to distill it down,
yeah,
what's the key takeaway, the aha moment for our listener?
For me, it's the power of creating a holistic experience.
Okay.
Caesarius isn't just playing music. He's created a world.
Mm-hmm.
He's engaging your senses, your emotions, even your intellect.
Yeah. And he's doing it all on his own terms, too. Pure creative vision and a really keen understanding of how to actually share that vision with the world.
And, you know, it makes you wonder,
yeah,
how can other artists or even just people in general apply this kind of thinking?
Right. Because it goes beyond the music, doesn't it?
It really does.
It's about finding those points of connection that make your passion resonate with like a wider audience.
It's about understanding that we're all interconnected.
Right.
And that by embracing diversity, by sharing our passions authentically, like we can create something truly special.
Caesarius has like cracked the code in a way.
He really has.
He's not just playing music.
Right.
He's sparking conversations. He's building bridges. He's reminding us of the power of human connection.
Mm-hmm.
And he's doing it all with a contagious smile and a whole lot of soul.
Absolutely.
So as we kind of wrap up this deep dive.
Yeah.
What's the one thing you hope our listener takes away from Caesarius's story?
I think the biggest takeaway is this. Don't underestimate the power of your own passions.
Mm-hmm.
whether it's music, art, food, whatever it is, whatever moves you,
Yeah.
there's a way to share that passion with the world and create something truly meaningful.
Wow.
Caesarius is living proof of that.
He's turned his rhythm into a global tapestry.
Beautifully said.
And it's an invitation for all of us to kind of find our own rhythm,
Yeah.
our own way to connect and contribute to the world's symphony.
I love that.
And on that note, we'll wrap up this deep dive into the captivating world of Caesarius.
Fantastic.
Go explore his music, feel that energy,
Yeah.
and let it inspire you to find your own unique rhythm in this grand orchestra we call life.
Beautifully said.
Until next time, keep those ears open and those minds curious.